Dear students, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor of Mechanical Engineering, Anjaleyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again through the video lecture series on the subject heater mass transfer. So this is lecture number 5 on the module mass transfer, and we are going to solve problems in the mass transfer part 2. And we recap from the previous lectures. Isothermal evaporation of water. So we calculated the isothermal evaporation of water. There is an equation. Using that equation, we are going to solve the problem. So at the end of this lecture, the student will be able to solve problem on isothermal evaporation of water. We take example number 1. Estimate the diffusion rate of water at 27 degrees Celsius from the bottom of a test tube of 0.02 meter diameter and 0.04 meter long into dry air at 27 degree Celsius. Take the diffusion coefficient of water in air as 0.26 in 10 power minus 4 meters square per second. So this is from Anna University question paper November 2007. So write down the given data. So T equal to temperature equal to 27 degree Celsius, which is 300 Kelvin, diameter equal to 0.02 meter, and X2 minus X1. The length of the air column is 0.04 meter and diffusion coefficient is 0.26 in 10 power minus 4 meter square per second. And the area of the test tube is pi by 4 d square, which is 3.14 in 10 power minus 4 meter square. And from the steam table, the saturation pressure at 27 degrees Celsius, which is PW1, partial pressure of water vapor at the bottom of the test tube, which is 0.0354 into 10 power 5 newtons per meter square. The other parameters are universal gas constant is 8314.3 joules per kilogram mole Kelvin, molecular weight of water equal to 18, and total pressure is 1 atmosphere, which is 101325 newtons per meter square, and we assume partial pressure of water vapor at the top of the test tube equal to 0. And this is the equation. So MW equal to dA by RO into T into MW into total pressure divided by X2 minus X1 into logarithmic of total pressure minus PW2 divided by total pressure minus PW1. So PW2 is the partial pressure at the top of the test tube and PW1 is the partial pressure at the bottom of the test tube. And substitute numerical values, D equal to 0.26 in 10 power minus 4, area equal to 3.14 in 10 power minus 4, RO equal to 8314.3, T equal to 300 Kelvin, MW equal to 18, total pressure is 101325 newtons per meter square, X2 minus X1 equal to 0.04, logarithmic of total pressure minus 0 divided by total pressure minus 3564. So, solving MW equal to 5.34 into 10 power minus 7 kilograms per second or 1.92 to 10 power minus 5 kilograms per hour. So, that is what the mass of the water evaporated. So the answer to the problem, mass of water evaporator is 1.9 to 10 power minus 5 kilograms per hour. We take another example from November 2016 question paper. Narrow cylindrical vessel contains water at the bottom. It is 5 meter deep and 2.5 meter diameter. The water is diffused to dry ambient air over the top of the vessel. The entire arrangement is maintained at 30 degrees Celsius and 1 atmosphere. The diffusion coefficient is 0.24 in 10 power minus 4 meters square per second. Calculate the rate of diffusion of water into air. The similar type of problem with different numerical data. The total pressure is 1 atmosphere. Temperature is 30 degrees Celsius, which is 303 Kelvin. Diameter equal to 2.5 meter and X2 minus X1 equal to 5 meter. Diffusion coefficient is 0.24 in 10 power minus 4 meters square per second, and the area of the vessel equal to pi by 4 d square. So pi by 4 into 2.5 square equal to 4.9065 meters square. And from steam table, the saturation pressure at 30 degrees Celsius, PW1 equal to 0.04242 bar, which is 0.04242 in 10 power 5 newtons per meter square, and other constants are universal gas constant 8314.3 joules per kilogram mole Kelvin, molecular weight of water is 18, total pressure is 1 bar, 1 atmosphere, which is 101325 liters per meter square, and the partial pressure at the station 2 is 0, And the same equation, what we used in the earlier previous problem, substitute the numerical values, 0.24 into 10 power minus 4 into 4.90625 area divided by 8314.3 into 303 into 18, molecular weight is 18, total pressure is 102325, x1 minus x1 equal to 5, and logarithmic of substituting the pressure and calculating the values, MW equal to 7.29 10 power minus 7 kilograms per second, or 2.62 10 power minus 3 kilograms per hour. So the answer to the problem, mass of water evaporator is 2.62 10 power minus 3 kilograms per hour. We take the third example from November 2007 question paper. Determine the mass of water vapor diffusing through a column height of 10 meter if the total pressure is 1 atmosphere and the partial pressure of the water at the bottom is 0.1 atmosphere and at the top is 0.03 atmosphere. The diffusion coefficient is 0.26 in 10 power minus 4 meter square per second. Write down the given data. Pressure equal to 1 atmosphere, x2 minus x1 equal to 10 meter. Partial pressure of water vapor at bottom of the vessel is 0.1 atmosphere. Partial pressure of water at the top of the vessel is 0.03 atmosphere. Diffusion coefficient is 0.26 in 10 power minus 4 meter square per second. We take area equal to 1 meter square and other values. Universal gas constant RO 8314.3 joules per kilogram mole Kelvin. Molecular weight of water equal to 18. Total pressure is 1 atmosphere, which is 101325 newtons per meter square. PW1, partial pressure of water vapor at 1.1 atmosphere, which is 101325 Pascal. And PW2, partial pressure of water at 0.2, which is 0.03 atmosphere, which is 3039.75 Pascal. Temperature T at PW1 equal to 0.1 bar, which is 45.83 degrees Celsius, which is 318.83 Kelvin. Now substituting, you take the previous equation, same equation for calculating the mass of water evaporated. So dA by RO into T equal to into MW PT divided by x2 minus x1 into logarithmic of P2 minus PW2 divided by PT minus PW1. Substituting all the numerical values, 0.26 in 10 power minus 4, area equal to 1 meter square. RO value, temperature is 318.83 and 18 molecular weight, 101325 divided by 10 is the distance. And substituting the partial pressure, calculating mass of water evaporated is 1.34 10 power minus 7 kilograms per second, which is equal to 4.82 in 10 power minus 4 kilograms per hour. So the mass of water evaporated is 4.82 10 power minus 4 kilograms per hour. In example number 4, an open pan, this is from various university questions, November 2005, November 2006 and November 2016. An open pan 20 cm in diameter and 8 cm deep contains water at 25 degrees Celsius is exposed to dry atmospheric air. If the rate of diffusion of water is 8.5 in 10 power minus 4 kilograms per hour, estimate the diffusion coefficient of water in the air. And the given data, pressure is 1 atmosphere, temperature is 25 degrees Celsius, which is 298 Kelvin, and diameter is 0.2 meter, x2 minus x1 equal to 0.08 meter. And mass of water evaporated is 8.5 10 power minus 4 kilograms per hour. And the area of the open pan is pi by 4 d square, which is pi by 4 into 0.2 square equal to 0.0314 meter square. And from steam table at 25 degrees Celsius, PW1 partial pressure is 0.03166 bar, which is 0.03166 in 10 power 5 meters per meter square. And other constants are universal gas constant is 8314.3 joules per kilogram mole Kelvin. Molecular weight of water is 18, total pressure is 1 bar, which is 101325 newtons per meter square, and the partial pressure of water vapor at the 0.2 equal to 0. And to calculate the diffusion coefficient of water, we take the same equation. Now the left hand side MW is given, 8.5 10 power minus 4 kilograms per hour, so divide by 3600, D is the unknown, substituting all the other parameters, A equal to 0.0314, RO equal to 8314.3, temperature equal to 298, molecular weight is 18, total pressure is 101325, and the distance is 0.038, and substituting the partial pressure and calculating the left hand side is D into 0.00915, sorry, left hand side is 2.36 10 power minus 7, and right hand side is D into 0.00915, and calculating the diffusion coefficient is 2.58 in 10 power minus 5 meters square per second for water. So the answer diffusion coefficient is 2.58 in 10 power minus 5 meters square per second. And example number 5, the diffusivity of carbon tetrachloride CCl4 in air is determined by observing the steady state evaporation of CCl4 in a tube of 1 cm diameter exposed to the air. The CCl liquid level is 10 cm below the top hole level of the tube. The system is held at 25 degrees Celsius and 1 bar pressure. And the saturation pressure of CCl4 at 25 degrees Celsius is 14.76 kPa. If it is observed that the rate of evaporation of CCl4 is 0.1 grams per hour, determine the diffusivity of CCl4 into air. So the total pressure is 1 bar, temperature is 25 degrees Celsius, 298 Kelvin, diameter is 0.01 meter, x2 minus x1 equal to 0.1 meter, that is 10 centimeter below, mass of the CCl equal to 0.1 grams per hour, and partial pressure of the CCl P1 equal to 14.76 kPa, and area of the tube equal to pi by 4 d square, which is pi by 4 into 0.01 square equal to 7.85 10 power minus 5 meter square. And the universal gas constant is 8314.3 joules per kilogram mole Kelvin. Molecular weight of CCl4 equal to 153.84. This is from the page number 184, Heater Master Answer data book. Total pressure is 1 bar, which is 10 power 5 newtons per meter square. And partial pressure of CCl4 at 2 equal to 0. So, diffusion coefficient for CCl4, we write the previous equation for CCl4 again. MCCl4 equal to dA divided by RO into T into molecular weight of CCl4 into total pressure divided by x2 minus x1 into logarithmic of total pressure minus P2 divided by total pressure minus P1. Partial pressure at location 1, bottom of the test tube. P2 is the partial pressure at the top of the test tube. So the left hand side, 0.1 grams per hour. So 0.1 divided by 3600 into 1000. So equal to D into area is 7.85 10 power minus 5. RO equal to 8314.3, temperature is 298 Kelvin, and the molecular weight is 153.84, pressure is 1 lakh newtons per meter square, distance is 0.1 meter, and substituting the partial pressure, calculating left hand side is 2.78 10 power minus 8, right hand side is D into 7.783 10 power minus 4, so diffusion coefficient for carbon tetrachloride CCl4 is 3.57 10 power minus 5. Meter square per second. So the diffusion coefficient is 3.57 10 power minus 5 meter square per second. We take example number 6 from the November 2009 question paper. Determine the diffusion coefficient of carbon tetrachloride in air if it evaporates at a rate of 0.012 grams per hour from a tube of 0.2 centimeter diameter is 0.2 cm diameter and 0.45 cm long. It evaporates at a temperature of 0 degrees Celsius into dry air at a pressure of 760 mm of mercury. The vapor pressure of carbon tetrachloride at 0 degrees Celsius is 33 mm of mercury. And the given data, write down the given data, P equal to 760 mm of mercury, temperature equal to 0 degrees Celsius, which is 273 Kelvin. Diameter equal to 0.02 meter, x2 minus x1 equal to 0.45 meter, MCCl4 equal to 0.012 grams per hour, and the partial pressure at the bottom of the test tube equal to 33 millimeter of mercury. We calculate the area of the tube, area equal to pi by 4 d square into, it is equal to pi by 4 into 0.02 square, which is 3.14 10 power minus 4 meter square. And RO is the universal gas constant, which is 8314.3, molecular weight of CCl4 equal to 153.84. Total pressure is 101325 newtons per meter square and partial pressure at the top of the tube equal to 0. And substituting in the equation, MCCl4 equal to 0.012 divided by 3600 into 1000 equal to D is the unknown, 3.14 10 power minus 4 divided by 8314.3 into 273. Molecular weight is 153.84 into pressure is 101325 divided by 0.45, which is 760 minus 0 divided by 760. Minus 33, calculating the left hand side 3.3 10 power minus 9 and right hand side is D into 2.13 10 power minus 4. So the diffusion coefficient is 1.56 10 power minus 5 meter square per second. So the answer is diffusion coefficient of CCl4 equal to 1.56 in 10 power minus 5 meter square per second. And these are the reference books I used for preparing the slides. You can also refer to it for additional information. And this is the book what I have published earlier. You can reach to it for additional problem and the theory. And if you have any queries, you can write to me to mail ID. I will answer. Thank you for watching. Thank you.